Now what do you do? You satisfy? No, 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 no. Go and follow him up. You go to his house now. Go and pester the life out of him. Because if he made a crack in you, he'll never let you go until you're converted. Do you know that? Until you're baptized. Damn it all, why should you be just satisfied with just making a crack? No, no, no. It must be a complete change. Until one day he tells you, say, I don't want you to darken my door again. The next time you come here, I'll put a bullet through you. Then you say, as Allah tells us in the Quran, وَإِذَا خَاتَبَهُمُ الْجَاهِلُونَ قَالُوا سَلَامًا. When you meet the ignorant, then you say peace. But otherwise, you make his life miserable. He wanted to make it to you. Take his name and address down, his telephone number down. Now talk. And follow it up. Okay, so we have to persevere. It's not just a lifetime of programming. In 1 hour you think, why didn't you do the job? He, you know, I tied him up. Why doesn't he accept Islam? No, it's not that easy. Lifetime of programming. You have to persevere longer. Yes, my son.
I want to make 3 points to you, brother. First of all, my point is...
Speak in the mic, yes.
You said that the...
It's not a PA system, but if he speaks in the mic, yes.
That we should learn from the masters, the kafirs. First of all, they're not masters, they're evil-minded. And we don't need to learn from the enemy, we have the Quran.
We don't need... You know, this. When I tell you in the class, I'll describe this in the language befitting this book here. I can't use the language here now, right? Why the hell must we use this when we have got the Quran? But I said, look, that's what Allah tells you. So the reason why you are not doing the job, why you can't do the job, we haven't done the job, is because you don't know what weapon the enemy is carrying. Every time we get a beating in the Middle East from the Jews, you know why? Because we don't know what he's armed with. He's better armed than us. The American is better armed, better informed than us. That's all. He's not a superman. He didn't come from heaven. So to fight the enemy, you must know his weapons. And Allah is telling you, the ayah I quoted you, وَقَالُوا لَنْ يَدْخُلَ الْجَنَّةَ إِلَّا مَنْ كَانَ هُدًا أَوْ نَصَارًا. They say that you Muslims will never enter Jannah. There's no heaven for you. Unless you become a Jew or unless you become a Christian. In answer to that, Allah says, "Tilka amaniyum," that this is their wishful thinking, vain desires, hallucination. They're just babbling. Don't get frightened. Qul, tell them, "Hatu burhanakum." You understand Arabic? MashaAllah. Qul, tell them, "Hatu burhanakum." Produce your proof, your certificate, your diploma that entitles you to Jannah and destines us to Jahannam. Let us have a look at your certificate. Does Allah tell you that? Qul, say, hatu burhanakum. Burhan, proof, produce your proof. So the guy produced it. Here's my proof. He said, my Bible says this, my Bible says that. He said, no, the Bible is not the word of God. So he said, the Quran is not the word of God. He said, this is fabricated. He said, the Quran is fabricated. Where will you come to? A punch up. I said, I can't afford that. See, judo, this is judo, intellectual judo. You know judo? This is intellectual judo. He said, come on, man, let's see. What have you got? In any claim, anybody makes any claim, at any time, ask him for his proof. Qul hatu burhanakum is the most sensible, common sense thing to do. Did you ask him for his burhan? The Christian in 1,000 years? You didn't. There are 10 million Christians in Egypt. Do you know that? Arab Christians, 10 million. There are 5 million others, 15 million Arab Christians in the world. Did you ask him for his burhan in 1,000 years? He said Christ died for his sins. Am I right? Jesus is God and the begotten Son of God. Did you ask him for his burhan? When I say you, I'm not talking about you. I'm talking about our learned men, the Muslim world. Did you ask the Jew for his burhan? Did you ask the Christian for his burhan? Allah is telling you, ask him for his burhan. Simple. Elementary statement. Hatu burhan. That guy is not interested in your Quran. No, there is a type of people. Allah says, minhumul mu'minuna, there are good people among them, wa aktharuhumul fasiqun. The good people talk about the Quran, talk about Islam, the hygiene, our laws, brotherhood, sobriety. Beautiful, it'll do a job. But we say, وَأَكْثَرُهُمُ الْفَاسِقُونَ. But the majority of them are perverted transgressors. You going to use the Quran? Jesus says, do not throw that which is holy unto dogs. Do not throw pearls before swine. That's what you're doing. To the dogs and the pigs, you don't put zamzam water. They need fire. See, my father told me, he says, my son, when you fight the devil, you don't fight him with zamzam water. You can't subdue shaitan with zamzam water. I don't know what idea you have about zamzam water. You think you can make shaitan into a saint with zamzam water? You dip him and take him out? No. My father said, burn him with fire. Fire! You have to burn shaitan with fire. So now I teach you how to fight with fire. This is that. His own, use it against him, and you see how easy, tantalizing, pleasurable. Wallah, he has come with it under his arm. You just tell him, he wants to, he's asking you questions now. He said, what this last day, kingdom of God established, where? What does the Quran say? Where? He's asking you. He's asking you. Where will the kingdom of God be established? Where? On this earth or in heaven? Where? Bulk of us, wallah. We haven't done the reading. One third of the Quran speaks about heaven, hell, and hereafter. Did you know that? No, hardly anybody knows. One third of the Quran speaks about heaven, hell, and hereafter. One third. How many of us know? Look, we haven't read it ourselves. We haven't. I haven't, wallah. See, I'm only reading what I need. So what I need, you create a need, a problem for me, I'm looking for a solution. Then I come and give it to you. I don't know the whole Quran. I don't know who knows the whole Quran. You go and ask a brother, say, look, what does the Quran say? Now the Christian is asking you that. He's got a Bible under his arm. He's prepared now, he's read your book. He's asking you, what does the Quran say? Where will the heaven be established? He said, what does the Quran say? So you can't say, go and see my Sheikh Zahran. Will you say that? No, it's not befitting. Go and see Mr. Deedat. Will you say that? Not befitting. You want to give battle? Huh? You want to give everybody? I'm talking, when I say you, I'm talking about all of us. You want to give battle, you have no knowledge. So now I have to teach you. I says, no, my son, that guy is a black belt karate expert. He's trained to come along and ask you these questions. Now, if you play the game according to his rules, you'll come out second best. Now, what you have to do, you have to turn the tables. So I tell you, I says, my son, you see what you do? Tell him, confess, man, confess. Then look, my brother, friend, I know very little about the Quran. I'm ashamed of myself. I'm a Muslim, born Muslim. But there's hardly anything I know about the Quran. Admit it, all of us. But you know your Bible. Say yes. You know your Bible. Say yes. If you say no, then say, foot sack, get away, man, you bloody rubbish. You don't know your own Bible and you talk about the Quran? Get away! He's got to say yes, because he's got Bible under his arm. He's come along to push it down your throat. He said, you know something about your Bible? I said, yes. He said, can I have a look at it? Is that a Bible? I said, yes. He gives it to you. And I show you the primer, how to prime this. You have primed it. You just open up. I'll show you what to do, how to mark it, highlight it. You have done that. Not his Bible, in your Bible you have done it. You know where what is there. He said, right. Open up Genesis chapter 19. Open Genesis chapter 19. Verse 30, read! That's how you do the job. Open Genesis chapter 35, verse 22, read! Your book, you explain to me. That guy will never darken your door. You see, so, number one, we have to use this rubbish, you know, to fight him. You can't fight the devil with holy water.
Brother, I'd just like to know, why the disbelievers, they hate Muslims. I'm talking about either Jewish or Christians. They hate Muslims. We're not, it's classical and ordinary question. Worse than that, they know about Dawah, they know about everything, but they don't want to know nothing. They don't want to hear nothing from us. They don't want to listen, nothing. We talk to them, we explain to them. We're not asking them for their money or their fortune or nothing at all. Just asking to show them, but they just close their ears and...
No, see, we are coming at cross purposes, let's say with the Christians. He says sin is inherited. We say, no, sin is not inherited. Sin is acquired. From the word go, we are now a tug of war. He says, sin is inherited. Everybody is a sinner. Everybody goes to hell. Unless you believe that Christ died for your sins. So number one, we say, no, sin is not inherited. Right? Number two, he says, Jesus is God. We say, no, he's not God. He said, Christ was crucified. He says, no, wama kataluhu wama salabuhu. He's going to like you. He says, God is the Trinity, Father, Son, and Holy Ghost. You say, wala takulu thalasa. Don't say Trinity. Intahu khairan lakum. This is, stop it, it'll be better. You think anybody likes that? Anybody likes that? No. So you have to learn. Huh? Look, that is the fact. Whatever he's telling is wrong, wrong, wrong. But now we have to find ways and means of getting at that fellow. And the best way is ask him, where did you get this? He says, it's in my book. So let's have a look. What does it say? If you can humble yourself, let us see. Come on, let's have a look, man. Jesus is God? He said, yes. Did he say he's God? He said, yes. So where? Show me. In my lectures, in my debates, I'm telling the Christian, you show me anywhere in your Bible, anywhere, in any version of the Bible, where Jesus says, I'm God, I said, I'm prepared to accept him as God. If where Jesus says, worship me, I'm prepared to worship him. I said, I don't speak for these people. For you, I can't speak for you. I speak for myself. Show me. Finish. The guy is stumped. No argument. I said, you show me and I'll accept. You say, it's not there. I said, you're asking me? Your book. You show me. Where Jesus says, I'm God, I'm prepared to accept him. Where he says, worship me, I'm prepared to worship him. So in other words, now because I know his book, I can offer him that. And now he's stumped in front of 2,000 people. The guy's stumped. Say, Christ died for my sins. He said, wait, how? Talk to him. Allah says, kul hadu burhan. Ask him for his burhan. Once Allah is telling you that he hasn't got a leg to stand upon. That's as if the judge is telling you, go to town with the fellow man, smash him up, man. I know he's a liar, he's a liar, he's a liar. Go and make a mess of him. The judge is telling you. And you're not doing it. The judge is telling you, this guy is a liar, he's a fake. And you're doing nothing. You must go to town. Come, man. Let us talk. Let us reason together. That is the strength. See, you're speaking from strength. Now, come. I'm prepared to listen to you. What have you got? So that's what I'm showing you. Use his book. Allah says, "Qul hatu burhanakum." Ask him for his burhan. He produced it, 11 different Arabic dialects. For you, Arabs, 11 different Arabic dialects. What excuse you got now? Huh? In 2,000 different languages. I just come from Sudan. I went to the Sudan. They have done 40 different Southern Sudanese language, Bible. They are at war with the Dinkas in the south. The Dinka, they got 4 different Dinka dialects, Bible in 4 different Dinka dialects. But now you haven't learned the art. That guy comes from 10,000 miles, he learns the language of the native and converts him and strengthens him, uses the Bible as a textbook for teaching him literature. He's doing the job, brainwashing the guy. And you're going to tell him, no, this is no good, it doesn't work. He's given it to you in your language. So we have to learn from the enemy to do the job. I don't know. I'm trying to learn from the enemy. Myself to invent the wheel is not for me. I haven't got that energy or the time to invent the wheel, a new wheel. You know wheel? It's invented, man. Right. Whoever has take it and improve on that wheel. Don't start wanting to say, no, I'm going to make my own wheel. So I'm learning from the enemy. This is what he is doing. I said, right, if I do the same thing with my book, the Quran is there. There is a type of man, you talk about the Quran. There's a type of man, perverted transgressor. As soon as you open your mouth about the Quran, say, where did it come from? I said, no, it was revealed to the Holy Prophet Muhammad. Muhammad, how many wives did he have? He's making a mockery. Right? He spread his religion at the point of the sword. He forced people, he slammed down people's throat. Fight. No, don't do that. I said, learn this judo. You know, use the force of your enemy and you see you go far better, longer, with less strength. You don't need that amount of strength if you use the strength of your enemy. This is inshallah. Next one, myself. Wa alaykum as-salam.
You said this book stand in the corner and smile would solve a lot of problems. Do you think Muslims who are being persecuted and executed in Algeria, Muslims in Burma, Muslims in Kashmir, in Palestine, need this book for the solution? Do you think that is the true solution? And also with that, to extend from that question, brother, inshallah,
I had all your problems. Algeria, you have a problem. Kashmir, you have a problem. In India, we have a problem. In Palestine, we have a problem. Now, with this one pellet, with one this little pebble, you want to solve all the problems? No, I never claimed it. I said, this Jalut who's knocking at your door, this is how you can shut him up. This is how you can educate him. Because that guy is not going to wait till you solve all your problems. He's stealing your children in the meantime. In Algeria, he's stealing your children. In Kashmir, he's stealing your children. In Bangladesh, in Pakistan, in Indonesia, in Malaysia, all over the world here, man, it's a godsend opportunity for them to steal your children here. Aren't they coming and knocking at your door? So now, to me, I'm only telling you how to deal with this Jalut, the American, the British, the French, whoever it is, who's trying to steal your children. I said, now, this is how to fight him. You tell me how you're going to solve the problem in Algeria? I said, brother, there are better people than me there, Algeria. About Palestine, I said, there are better people than me to solve the problem of Palestine. I'm not here as a god to tell you solve all your problems. I'm only telling you, this guy here is trying to steal your children. This is how you can defend yourself. A one-day survival course. I want to give you a survival course against this enemy. And when you have time, I'll also tell the Algerians I'm supposed to go there and tell them something. And tomorrow, go tell them something. For everybody, I have something. But now, at the right place. Here, I'm going to tell you what you're going to do in Algeria. What am I doing? I'm wasting your time. And in Pakistan, in Kashmir, what you must do? In Indonesia, what am I doing? I said, you, can you do this? Yeah, if you fit in, okay. If not, inshallah, we'll carry on with this work. But now, this is just for the moment. Here. In your environment, I say you need this, you need this. In America, you need this.
Well, I didn't finish my question. I said, because for me, they haven't stolen our belief. They've stolen our system from us. That's what they've destroyed. But to take the question further, this book, saying it's different for Indonesia and all those countries, but what about this book for our corrupt rulers who claim to be Muslims, like Fahd, Sabah, Hosni Mubarak, Assad? Because they are the biggest oppressors of Muslims and implementing the deen. Is this a solution? Or is the Quran the solution? And fi sabilillah. That was my question, really.
So you see, my brother, to me, I feel you are a better man to change Fahad than me. You are a better man to change Mubarak than me. I take it that you speak Arabic.
No.
Well, learn Arabic. You see, learn Arabic, and I think you'll do a better job. You see, this is a world of specialization. You're specializing in something, aren't you, at school? What are you doing at present?
I'm doing Arabic and politics. I'm learning Arabic.
Right, there you are, in politics. You see, he's going into politics. That means you are equipping yourself, mashallah, for that field. I am not equipped. I was forced into this area, and in this area I have become an expert. So my expertise I'm now sharing with you. That's all, in this field. You tell me to solve all the world problems of the world. I said, no, I don't know, brother. I don't. I can't.
No, I'm not asking you to.
So I said, now, you say, this or that. I said, no. You be an expert in politics, you do that field. Somebody want to become a Sufi, want to fly in the air, okay. No, I'm serious. Look, if you can make people, right, you will read people's minds, okay, you teach that science. I don't know. You say, look, first woman, I said, look, please leave me alone. This is all that I know. I'm showing you my weakness. In specialization, that's your weakness. If you're a specialist, you are right on top there, but in something else, you know nothing about. You're a doctor, medical doctor. You can't change a fuse, man, fuse. Your wife's fuse goes off, damn it all, you can't change the fuse. But now, look at that, he didn't learn about changing fuse. That carburetor in the motor car, he can't adjust that. And you are a doctor, B-A-L-L-B. What kind of a donkey is this? I said, no, look, that's his different field. You are a doctor. I am a doctor in this field. If I can be of help to you in this field, at the moment, this is all that I can do. I'm not going to take on the world because I know I'm committing suicide. I just want my soldiers. You are my soldiers. My soldiers, can my soldiers do this? That's all I'm going to give you. I won't tell you to pray five times a day. Then somebody else must tell you that. You know, make tahajjud and make ishraq and read subhanallah so many times. That's not my job. Me, I said, can you do this? So that you're my soldier to do this job. That's all. The rest of it, there's somebody else telling you your beard must be standard size, This Nasara clothes you are wearing, me too. He said, look, you must make Islamic clothes. That's not my line. I said, let the other guy do that. I'm not coming in his way. I won't come in your way. You know, when you talk politics, political science, what you know and what you understand and how to do things, I will follow you. I will follow you. See when you give the lead. But for the time being, this is all that I can do to help people. Next one, brother. Next one.
Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Today there is a new holy trinity. Isn't the Father, the Son, the Holy Spirit?
Yes.
It's capitalism, democracy, and freedom. This is the new holy trinity that we see in the world. We talk about Christianity, but from my limited experience as somebody who's a student and who actively partakes in Islamic society, people don't care about Christianity. If you look in the world today, it isn't Christianity that's been implemented. It's capitalism, democracy, or freedom. So I think the real problem that should be addressed are these problems, because as Muslims, we have a stigma. We get upset when we hear a Muslim has become Christian. But there are many millions of Muslims who become Democrats, who become secularists. We don't make a big deal about this. So I feel our energies will be better put to use if we tackle these problems. It's because it's capitalism today that's a dominant force in the world today.
This, my son, I agree with you 100%. You see, you are the fittest guy for that job. You want to pass the buck onto somebody else. This idea is what you gave now about democracy and communism and all that. You are the fittest guy for that unholy trinity you talked about just now. Right? But now you want to find somebody, a scapegoat, somebody to do the job. You are a coward. Everybody, I'm telling you, now when you come with an idea, any idea, new idea, you say, Mr. Deedat, why don't you do this, like this, like that? I said, my son, Allah chose you for that. If he inspired you, what he inspired you with, he has chosen you to do that job. But you coward, you, please don't take offense. I said, you coward, you look at Sheikh Dahran, why doesn't he do that? Ahmed Deedat, why doesn't he do that? You are a coward. You are the right person to do that job. But you want to shirk that responsibility. He said, you want to pass it on to me? I said, please, man, I'm telling you my weakness. I'm telling you, I have no knowledge about what you're talking.
Confuse the issue with Christianity, because Christianity is not the issue.
Did any Christian come and knock at your door?
No, alhamdulillah.
Where do you live?
I live in London.
Huh?
I live in
where about in London?
North London.
Huh?
North London.
In an ivory tower?
No.
You are like the invisible man. Maybe the Christians can't see you.
Maybe they're scared of me.
Maybe that, you see. So in other words, they know that this guy here is a greater devil than us, so he keeps them away from you. But our people, we know, they're harassing our people all over. All these books that I was showing you, see what they're doing? Christ gave the key in your hand. See this? Christian witness among Muslims. See this guy here? Better Muslim looking than most of us. Huh? K.K. Alawi is the key to us in search of assurance. He's a murtad, he wants to make you a murtad. I haven't shown you all. What I've got here, you want to catch your daughters now. See this? You want to catch your daughters now. She may never know a Christian. She may never meet a Christian. But you can write to her about God's love. Either you know what's going on around you or you don't. See, like an ostrich with the head in the sand, you don't know what I'm telling you, that the house is on fire, they're stealing our children. In Pakistan, they have perverted more Pakistanis into Christianity since independence than in the previous 100 years of British rule. They have perverted more Bangladeshis into Christianity since independence than the previous 100 years of British rule. They have perverted 15 million Indonesians into Christianity. And by the turn of the century, they want to make Indonesia a Christian nation. There are 35,000 full-time Christian missionaries occupied in Africa at the present moment. And we say, we talk about democracy and this. All that, you are an expert. I'm telling you that this devil here is stealing my children, and I can't afford to lose one. And don't tell me that you don't know that we have lost a Muslim to Christianity. Otherwise, you are absolutely blind. In your environment, have you ever known if a Muslim becoming a Christian or not? Right, okay. Are you satisfied?
No. I'm unhappy about it. I know 10 who have become Democrats.
They can't. Right. So now that you change them, you keep them, save all these people from becoming Democrats. That's your job. My job is to save them from becoming Christians. I'm going to try to save you by giving you that survival course that inshallah you can become an adulterer, a drunkard and all that, but you won't become a Christian. That is the antidote I'm trying to give you. You know, an injection to save you from Christianity. He must give you an antidote against democratization. Okay, inshallah. Next one.
Since, can I just come in here?
We've only got 20 more minutes left, so I'd appeal to all of you to please stick to the topic. Ask a question that's relevant to what Sheikh Deedat has been speaking about. And I would also remind Sheikh that we have only 25 minutes left.
We'll finish before that.
Okay, brother. The subject is Dawah in the UK, yeah? Now let's just look at what the predominant people in this country are. How many people attend the church? Very lucky if you get 2-3% of the whole country attending the church. They know that Christianity is something dead, does not apply to life. Now what does? You ask anybody, whether it's in a grammar school, whether it's in a anywhere, workplace, what do they really thrive on? Freedom, democracy. For example, if they bring out a certain issue like homosexuals, on what basis would they justify it? Someone say, oh, the Bible says this. No. They will say what they got to in their own free time, in their own privacy, consenting adults, etc., is up to them. Freedom. They argue on the basis of freedom. Now, with this argument that, you know, we don't want people to become Christians, why are they becoming Christians in Pakistan? It's because the system applied allows the propagation of kufr concepts. They do not implement Islam. What is Islam? They have a distinction between deen and dunya. Islam is not practical to them. If you implement Islam as a complete system, you will see the people coming to Islam. They will see the economic system from Islam. They will see all the justices. And I'm not shirking my responsibility. I'm only here for some support from the brothers to bring out the correct call of Islam as a complete political ideology. Now, I'm not shirking any of my responsibilities. And also, I don't agree with the idea that that's your responsibility. I'm a Muslim. I have to pray. I have to do all my responsibilities. And one of them is to deliver the call to the people in the context of what Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam did. So that does not mean I just say, no, I'll be specializing in doing wudu and prayer, and I won't do the fasting. No, all of it. What is known from Islam by necessity.
So what now?
So, I mean, what do you think of this idea?
I'm telling you, you are studying a certain science. You are also with the other brother. I'm sure you are also studying political science. You are well informed about, you say, the kufr system in Pakistan, Bangladesh, Indonesia, Malaysia, Egypt, everywhere there's a kufr system. So you know the system. Now you are the right man to go and give them the injection against that system. Inoculate them. No, please, don't pass the buck. I don't like cowards.
All of us,
I don't like.
No, unite. No. We give the call to the people.
You get people. Look, don't argue with me. You get the people. Inspire the other young men like yourselves. Say, come on now. Let us do an exercise. We'll have a debating society in which we're going to start, you know, debating about these things and inform the people. Go and deliver lectures. I'm sure Sheikh Rahman will allow you.
I'm ready.
Allow you.
Come.
Right. Go and call the people. Right. Yes. Now, don't. No use. You. I'm telling you now that, look, Allah is telling you, one-third of the Quran is addressed to Jews and Christians. One-third is addressed to Jews and Christians. Ya Ahl al-Kitab, Ya Ahl al-Kitab. Allah is crying in the Quran. He is crying in the Quran. He said, وَقَالُوا اتَّخَذَ الرَّحْمَنُ walada, and they say that Ar-Rahman, the merciful God, has begotten a son. He said, لَقَدْ جِئْتُمْ شَيْئًا عِدَّا. It's one of the most abominable assertion one can make. The worst swearing you can give Allah is this. تَكَادُ السَّمَاوَاتُ يَتَفَتَّرْنَا مِنْهُ. At it, the skies are ready to burst. وَتَنْشَقَّ الْأَرْضُ. And the earth to split asunder. وَتَخِرُّ الْجِبَالُ حَدَّا. And the mountains to fall down in utter ruin. أَنْدَ أَوْلِ الرَّحْمَنِ وَلَدَا. That they should say that Ar-Rahman, the merciful God, has begotten a son. I want to know, what are you doing about that when Allah is crying? When you go home and your mother says to you that, you know, this guy next door is calling me a whore. He called me a bitch. He called me a hooker. And you say, no, ma, you see, this kufr system, you know, we must change this. Is that what you're going to say to your ma?
No.
What are you going to say? You want to break the guy's jaw. Huh? The guy's calling your mother a hooker, a whore. What do you want to do? You want to break his jaw. Mm-hmm. No? Mm-hmm. Yes, me too.
But I'm restricted.
Right. Sure, yeah. So now, when Allah Bari Ta'ala is crying in the Quran, I want to know what you're prepared to do about that. He's not crying about Pakistan being run by a kufr system. He's crying that people are swearing me. Swearing Allah, and you say you love Allah more than anything else, you're not worried about that. You're worried about Pakistan and Bangladesh. I says to hell with them all. The thing is, now Allah is crying in the Quran. I want to know what you're prepared to do about that. Come. Here. Right. Okay. Next one.
Assalamu alaikum.
It seems to me that you are categorizing, you know, jobs in Islam. Like, this brother is good at hitting missionaries, this brother is good at, you know, doing this, this. You see, we have to deal with Islam as a whole, as a system.
Look, okay, same sickness.
Let me finish.
Your sickness, look, one, two, eight, all...
Akhi.
Look, wait.
Please.
What's your question on the subject I have spoken? Any question?
No.
You are telling me now all these other things I know. I want to know what is your question. Look, I spoke for more than an hour.
Okay.
Did you hear me?
Yes, I hear.
Right. So look, now look. I want to know is, have you got a question? I'm sure the Christian is putting something to you for which you have no answer.
No.
Or you have all the answers.
No. What I'm saying to you...
No, I don't want to hear what you want to say. I want you to answer me now. Do Christians ever come to you and ask you about Jesus Christ? He is your savior. And you have answer for that.
Of course, I have answer for everything.
You have answer for everything?
Yes, because when I have Islam, right? So now, Islam gives me the answer.
Then you are all...
I haven't come to my point.
Don't waste time. There's three more there.
Don't waste time.
Look, I'm telling you now.
Okay.
You have all the answers, so you're wasting time. Therefore, you want to take me on to other fields. If you haven't got an answer, then you ask me, says, uncle,
this guy
wants to know, why don't you people eat pig? When you eat the sheep and the goat and the cow, why don't you eat pig? And maybe he said, look, man, I told him like that, but is there a better answer than that?
Can I just make one point? Yeah?
One question. What point do you want to make now?
Okay, what I'm saying is, we're also dissociating ourselves from all the Muslim brothers. You are saying Indonesian brother is good for this, you know, Algerian brother is good for this. We have to deal with Muslim ummah as one ummah.
I don't know.
Okay?
Jazakallah. I don't know. These are our educated lads. I'm telling you, just come and do this job here, and now they want to create another job for me. Well, yes.
Yes, in order to give da'wah to other people or to those kuffar, are we allowed to grade them about their pagan festivals, like saying Happy Christmas or Happy New Year? If the answer is yes, I would like you to give me the evidence from the Quran and Sunnah.
No, I have it. You are great, my son. You see, when I said that Happy Christmas, Happy New Year, that doesn't mean, what is Christmas? What is Christmas?
It's pagan festival.
What is Christmas? What does Christmas mean? It means the birth of Christ.
Yeah, the birth
right.
of Christ.
Birth of our Nabi, we celebrate. Don't we?
We don't celebrate.
Yes?
We don't.
Maulud?
No, we don't celebrate. That is bid'ah. That is bid'ah. We don't celebrate.
You are...
Neither the Prophet Muhammad in his life nor the companion has been celebrated this...
Okay. There are millions of Muslims, including myself. I don't mind having a birthday celebration of the Prophet. You say bid'ah, I said, okay, my son, I'm not going to argue with you. I don't want to convert you. I don't want you to convert me. You see, I'm not here.
But Quran and Sunnah will judge between us.
Okay, leave it to Allah. That judgment, leave it to Allah.
No, how can we leave it to Allah?
Assalamu alaikum, brother. Brother, so many brothers, they want to see you debate with the Pope. Have you ever got chance to debate with the Pope?
No, the guy's too clever. He's too clever. He doesn't want to. No, he doesn't. He knows. See, he's cleverer than most people. He's cleverer than Swagat. He's cleverer than Shorosh. He knows. He doesn't want to make a fool of himself.
But he went to Mali and asked again the same thing. I want to dialogue with the Muslims.
That's a game. You see, he's playing. It's a game he's playing. He's a master psychologist. He's a master psychologist. Wherever he goes, he said, we must have a dialogue with the Muslims. Who the His Holiness, the Pope. When he went to Kenya, he said that. When he went to Nigeria, he said that. When he went to Turkey, he said that. Now he said that. And to Senegal, he said that. Now what he's actually telling his people, go and convert the Muslims. But he doesn't use the word convert. Because if you use the word convert, you're going to react. Because when the priest comes along with his dog collar, you're going to chase him away. Because he's going to steal your children. But when he talks about dialogue, you can't say no. Because Allah is telling us to have a dialogue with him. قُلْ يَا أَهْلَ الْكِتَابِ تَعَالَى. So you can't say no, but you'll come out second best. Because you're not trained for that. You are not trained for that. His missionaries are trained for that. So actually he's telling them, go and convert these people. They are already prepared to receive Christianity. They only need a gentle push. That's all. So that's actually what he's telling. So I caught him out. I said, right, Your Holiness, I'm prepared to come and have a dialogue with you. And it's a long story. The guy, he fizzled off. No, he doesn't mean dialogue. What he's talking about, telling his people, go and convert the Muslims. They're already prepared. See, they already believe that Jesus is the Masih, Messiah, Masihullah. They already believe in his miraculous birth. They already believe that he is the Messiah. They already believe that he gave life to the dead by God's permission, and he healed those born blind and the lepers by God's permission. What more is required? Give him a gentle push, man. That's all. So that's what he's telling his people. It's a game he's playing. Right, my son? But I see the queue is not. I see it's increasing. The queue.
Because of the time, I think we can only take two questions only, because we have one from the ladies also. So, Brother Wajid, and the rest, no more questions, please. Sorry.
Assalamu alaikum. Brother, you mentioned a book which you said is even more worse than Salman Rushdie's. If we don't read books like these because we don't want to publicize them, how will we know what is being printed about Islam? And if we don't know what is being printed, how can we fight against it? Thank you.
You see, it's not everybody's job. I don't know whether you bought the Satanic Verses by Rushdie. Did you buy it? Why didn't you?
Because
what I'm trying, it's a rhetoric question. What? How many of you have bought Satanic Verses? Please put up your hands. How many of you got the Satanic Verses at home? See? Look, in 200, 300 people, two persons got the Satanic Verses. You expect them all to buy Satanic Verses and read them, support that Khamis? You want to support him? Because every extra book that you buy, you're supporting the guy. Do you know that? You want to do that? No. This is for the experts. The experts have a right. Jamal Badawi, or Sheikh Zahran, or Ahmed Deedat, or whoever in the community, Kalim Siddiqui, these are the people, they must go out of the way to buy the book, study the book, and answer the book. It is not necessary for every Tom, Dick, and Harry, everybody to buy the book. Damn it all, what you going to do with that book? 500 and some 20 pages, how many pounds it costs you? What you doing? You want to go and buy that book? You want to make that guy popular? No, so in other words, I'm telling you, look, this is what's going on. I'm in the field. I'm monitoring it for you. I said, look, now for that, let's do this. Don't start making a noise. That Reverend so-and-so, Maury, he wrote this book in which he says, our Nabi didn't. Don't do that. What you're doing, you're propagating the shaitan. Then people want to know, anybody comes along with the book, you want to buy, because you have already spoken about it. You want to do that? I don't want to do that. See, Satanic Verses, I had the right to read and tell you what is there, how to fight it. Kalim Siddiqui, you must buy the book, read it, and tell you how to fight it. Right? But for each and every Muslim to buy that book, you say, you want to know what you want to know? Shit! You want to go into shit yourself? No, this is the doctor's job. You know, wanting to put his finger all over the place to find out what's wrong with you, that's not my job and everybody's job. Leave it to the specialist. Okay, my son?
I want to first start by making admission. I'm going to pass a buck to you. I'm going to pass one to you, but I'd like a buck of my own as well.
Right.
So if you would give me the opportunity, I'd like to take up the offer and one day give a talk here, inshallah.
Mashallah.
Is that okay?
Mashallah.
I'll give you my name and address afterwards. Because really, we all have a responsibility. And you yourself, since I was born, I used to hear about, well, when I grew older, one of the first things that brought me interest into Islam was some of your video cassettes. And I came to listen to you. Now, looking back now, you have an position that I don't enjoy, that none of these brothers enjoy. You have a position of influence. People listen to you. And yes, in Britain, we should deal with the kafir. We should explain to them what's wrong. We should show them the truth. But also, many Muslims come to listen to you and look to you with expectation. And although ourselves and myself as a Muslim 4 years ago, I knew what is kafir. I knew him. I knew who is kafir. But I did not recognize kufr. That's something we must understand is a distinction. What do I mean? Someone can be Pakistani and he can be kafir. We know that. But someone can be Pakistani and he carries kufr. How? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala describes in the Quran, إِنَّ هَذِهِ أُمَّتَكُمْ أُمَّةٍ وَاحِدًا. This, your nation, is one nation. In Islamic international law, forget UN, in Islamic international law, we are one nation, not Pakistani, not Malaysian, not one Indonesia. That's kufr. Sorry.
We didn't give you the time to lecture.
This is
not now, actually, huh? Let me finish.
He's taken the opportunity to lecture. Look, a time okay. Chance will be given to you.
Okay, inshallah, Ahmed Deedat, I just want to finish one thing, yes? Just one thing. We won't be late for Maghrib. Okay. The question is this now.
Please, brothers.
Yes, I tell you.
Brothers.
We want a question. You understand? All right. Let him ask the question. We don't need no more talk. That's enough.
It's a
banana. Ask the question.
Okay, I'll ask. Jazakallah khair.
Please.
Let's ask the Sheikh
a question and lay
man
to you.
Right.
Okay.
And I will ask
you
that question.
Imam Radin. Okay.
There is a panel, and the audience don't have the decision. The panel of the house has got the decision.
Imam Radin.
I can't believe it. You know, look.
Imam Radin, inshallah, if I don't have a chance today, I'll have a chance in future. Remember me in Dawah. Okay.
Tell us,
I'll tell you what. The question is, as a Muslim, I want to remove the munkar. When someone insults my mother, I hurt. When someone insults the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, I hurt. I want to remove the munkar. Yes, I can go to Christian debate with him. But the question is this: how can I implement the hudud on Salman Rushdie? I can't do it myself. The magic word comes again. I need system to do this. My hands are tied without the system. This is something we must realize.
We are very sorry. That's
first direction. Just before we finish, we've got two questions from the sisters.
Okay.
The first sister says that I disagree with you about the age. The first sister says, I disagree with you about the age for your dawah. My husband is 35 and gives dawah every week. I put it forward.
She didn't hear that even Sheikh Zahran might say, look, I'm young in spirit, and I might have to concede. So she didn't hear. 35, 40. If you feel you are young and you can give battle, Nur alhamdulillah. Welcome. Yes.
And the final question also from the sisters is, how can we help our brothers and sisters to realize that the non-Muslims are brainwashing us gradually?
Can I comment on that? You see, an incident happened with me. Last week, some people of Jehovah's Witness came to my flat, knocked at the door and said, we got good news for you. Will you please let us in? So I let them in. I was very busy. They started to speak the same topic, the same idea, the same language. I know that they are programmed. So my way, it may be sometimes devilish way. So what I do, I take them out of the track and start to ask them, tell me. Then a lady, one of them, said, you are a Muslim. I said, yes, I am a Muslim. She said, you know that the devil is working and the whole world is in trouble and this and that. I said, so what? She said, Allah, because she speaks Arabic, was speaking Arabic, Allah will come to rectify all that. I said, who is Allah? I don't know him. Believe me, I never saw him. So who is Allah? Who is he? That one who was in the cross, that is I saw. Yes, if that one was in the cross, if he couldn't help himself, how can he help me now? So long time, why he left me this long? What I mean that I took him out, I took all of them out of the trap, and they couldn't argue anything. And they said to me, we are very sorry, we came to the wrong address. I said, yes, that is emphasized, shows me definitely that they are programmed, they are brainwashed. When you take them out of that, nothing. They have nothing to say to you. So definitely, they are brainwashed. And you see, you can't imagine the guts of these people to come to the mosque to preach Christianity in the mosque
to the imam.
They are coming to convert us to Christianity. See, the danger of the matter. You look at it as a very simple thing. We have to look about the politics and it. But a person coming to your house, knocking your door, and trying to convert you to Christianity or to his system or to his religion, and you know how, you don't know how to answer that. So what our brother did, is to equip us in that field. And I like to say to our brother, who says, oh, there's no segregation or there is no sect is here to work that work or to do that field. That is the whole Quran says so. فَلَوْلَا نَفَرَ مِنْ كُلِّ طَائِفَةٍ مِّنْهُمْ طَائِفٌ لِيَتَفَقَّهُوا فِي الدِّينِ وَلِيُنذِرُوا قَوْمَهُمْ إِذَا رَجَعُوا إِلَيْهِمْ لَعَلَّهُمْ يَحْذَرُونَ. It means someone must specialize in that area, and one in that area, and one in that area, and that is the Holy Quran. If we understand the Holy Quran properly, that it tells us you have to specialize it, you have to divide the work. You can't do all the work. We can't do all the work. You can't do. I met someone, and that is the language of the Holy Quran. فَلَوْلَا نَفَرَ مِنْ كُلِّ فِرْقَةٍ مِّنْهُمْ طَائِفَةٍ لِيَتَفَقَّهُوا فِي الدِّينِ. Not everybody to go to study religion. No, someone. فَلَوْلَا مِنْ كُلِّ فِرْقَةٍ مِّنْهُمْ طَائِفَةٍ لِيَتَفَقَّهُوا فِي الدِّينِ. To learn religion and they come back to teach others who studied something else or who are specialized in some areas. So that is the Holy Quran tells us to do so. So I don't mean at all that we neglect the politics. We don't neglect our people. We don't neglect these talents. No, but there is areas, there is time, there is people to speak. That I had the idea one day to speak in the pulpit about the Muslims in Yugoslavia. But I'm waiting. Because I don't know all the facts. I invited one of the Yugoslavians from a Mosque to come to lecture us. If they have tapes, we will show it here. After that, I can talk about that in the pulpit. But what I got to say to now, what can I say? Nothing, because I have no idea. I have no full picture of it. So when I get it, I will do it. Now we have our problem, immediate problem. The knocking, the problem knocking every door, coming to us, and they will say, a good news, we are bringing to you a good news. Those who oppose to say, our brother doesn't need at all to share when he says, happy Christmas or happy New Year. He doesn't mean that you are sharing with them that, but if you go to tell anybody, do you imagine that he will accept you? You curse him and say, oh, take this book. What he will do? He will give you a slap, whatever may be you. But gently, nicely, and that is what? وَجَادِلْهُمْ بِالَّتِي هِيَ أَحْسَنْ. Don't go to the man and say, you are a kafir. I want you to be a Muslim or to know what is the truth. You have to take this book, whether you like it or not. What he will do with you? Does he accept you? Is it the language of the Holy Quran? It is the way of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam? No. And our brother doesn't mean at all when he says happy Christmas or that you are happy about the Eid or you are sympathizing, sharing with them. No, no, no. He wants to say gently, with a nice word, talk to the people with the nice words. That is all. What is the harm in that? But anyhow, thank you for tolerating us, all of us, except especially myself. Thank you to tolerate that. And we have to thank our brother Ahmed Deedat once more. Thank you, and wa akhiru da'wana. الحمد لله رب العالمين اللهم أرنا الحق حقا وارزقنا اتباعه وأرنا الباطل باطلا وأعنا على اجتنابه إنك على ما تشاء قدير. And I have to apologize that we, the imams of the center, we are very sorry if we are not doing the good job for Islamic da'wah in Britain. I'm very sorry. I declare that we are We intend to do our business or our job properly as it should be, and I have to admit that, and to admit that is to try to put our house right, and again, we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Allahumma ansurna ala a'da'ina, اللهم أعنا على القوم الظالمين اللهم لا تؤاخذنا بما فعل السفهاء منا إنك على ما تشاء قدير وصلى الله على سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم وشكر الله لكم جميعا.
أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله أشهد أن محمدا رسول الله